freestyle. In the USA, yes. Yes, I'm a resident. I ain't vote for no president. I'm all about truth. Anything else, you know it's irrelevant. I'm all about real TV, baby, so come and get relevant. If you talking about anything else to me, you know it's irrelevant. I rap for the Most High. I do it for Yahweh. I gotta live right, We gotta live right, Forget the Donald Trump, Like, yeah. The world is crazy, It's going to hell like a handbasket and a baby. Living the life right, doing the thing right, you know it's out of sight. We going up real high. I'm not from Atlanta. I'm from Savannah. I do it smooth. I rock bandana, and I don't gotta be a thug just to rock a bandana. I like banana, not like some mangoes. I love some chips. And I love some Pringles. And this is a freestyle. This is the freestyle. Real TV, real TV. You know me, This is a freestyle. My name is Michael. Lizards are real. They look like Geicos. You know it's just real. Real TV. The world is crazy. I'm still grown. I ain't got no baby. I want a wife. I'ma get a wife. I'ma get some land. I got a plan. I'ma get some produce. I'ma put it on my land. I don't like no mail. I like the postman. He give me my mail. I cut my cuticle. But I don't do my nails. I don't like no fungus. If you talking that trash, you know it is bogus. This is a freestyle. My name is Michael. Michael Israel. Like the archangel. I ain't no angel. I'm just trying to be right, right. Real TV. Real TV.
Yeah. We're going to give it up. For the Most High. Let's give a round of applause, all right? At one, and two, and three. All right, now that we did a round of applause, what we're going to do now is do a shout-out time, all right? So we're going to do a couple shout-outs, but have Michael Israel conduct the show, all right? But after these short messages on Real TV, baby. Real TV. One more second, Real TV. Just give me one quick moment for this short break. All right. Just one short moment. Just one more short moment. All right, let's go.
Yeah. You know, maybe one day you'll awake. Or maybe you're already awoken, but don't run away from the truth. We need the truth. Don't run away from the truth. Yeah. Hang in there. Run the race all the way to the end. Spending money, not the only thing we need to do. Giving money to the poor is what we need to do. A lot of lies in this world, but we need the truth. I know you wanna run away, but we need the truth. It's like we living in the cage, living in the zoo. Why you wanna run away when we need the truth?
And just like they do on a Sunday morning, not morning, but morning, we're going to give a couple shout outs today because you got to sing with it. I said, can I get a amen? I said, can I get a amen? Amen. Amen. Well, I said, can you say well? Well, can you say well? Well, said you gotta laugh with it. You gotta praise the Most High. I said you gotta praise. You gotta praise. You gotta praise the Most High. But before we do, I mean when we do, we just want to just give a couple of shout-outs to those who have been tuning into the show and showing love. You know, sometimes you got to switch it up. You got to have that energy. You know, energy doesn't lie. And I hope you got a couple of laughs on that. But today's show is going to be called Place Your Vote. Really quick about voting, what it means, why are you doing it. Hopefully you didn't do it. And we're going to deal with that. But I do want to give a couple of shout outs. I can't give a shout out to everyone, you know, but I do have a handful of people that I do want to give a small notion of gratitude and appreciation for your love and commentaries. And, you know, I think that is well deserved. There's over almost 2,000 something followers. I don't even like the word followers. There's like 2,000 something listeners, okay? Because you're not a follower of me, all right? Everything that I give to you in this podcast is from the sincerity of my heart that has been placed in me to give you this truth. You know, it's not my truth, it's just the truth. And you know, sometimes we just have to show that appreciation. And you know, I really give thanks, you know, because it's not me that you're really thanking, even though I'm putting in the work. It's the Most High, because all praises go to our Heavenly Father for this truth that is going out into the world. And for those who are on different levels and who may not understand the truth at this time, that's understandable, because we all were there at that point where we were asleep. And try waking up someone that's been asleep for a long time. No, try waking up someone that is in a good sleep, that is feeling good, nice and cozy. When you're sleeping good, if somebody wakes you up, somebody pushes you on your shoulder, if you hear the alarm, people want to break their alarms, want to break their phone when they're really tired. If someone nudges you and you really haven't had a good sleep and you've been sleeping for a while and they cut on the light, you're like, you're going to be upset. Cut off the light. You know what you, I mean, it just automatically, involuntarily causes you to have an emotion that is uncontrollable. But that emotion that is uncontrollable is just something that's within you that can be released and dealt with. But I hope that symbology helps you understand that there's different levels to it. You know, some people can get the truth right away. Some people have been looking for it, searching for it. Some people are just asleep and they're just in the world and so far left field that when they get anything close to it, or they just have this cognitive dissonance that it just can't be true, because they're still stuck in their own beliefs and the idea that something that they have learned in practice, in tradition, all their lives is humiliating. It's humiliating to know a specific type of truth that is new to you, because you feel so illiterate, you feel so dumb, you feel idiotic, because we don't want to go in that place. And sometimes when we know it's something that is importantly and seriously true, I mean, it immediately comes to doubt. Like, no, this is not black. Blacks are not the true Hebrews. Blacks are not Israel. I mean, not the entire black generation. There's a 2/3 of the black population that are not of, how can I say, that are not of the chosen few. But I don't want to get too far on the deep end. Let's give a few shout outs really quick, and then we'll take another quick short break, and we'll talk about place your vote. All right, in no particular order, okay? This is no particular order. I don't want anyone to become offensive. It takes too much time to put it in alphabetical order. It's just a handful of names that I'm just giving shots out to. So if I missed your name, don't feel offended. Don't feel like you're on the bottom of the totem pole. There's no particular order that I'm giving a shout out to. All right. So I just want to take some time here and give a shout out to Yahuwah Hirkiner, Jay Fox, Scream Queen, Ari Yahoo, Regina Muzenda, Anita Lay or Leah, Barbie Button, Even Riss, Kimbo Simpson, Aleya, Yahawashai, Bebe Bebe or Baby Baby, I Love the 70s, Raw Business Productions, Dark Coven, Nathan Grundler, Rose Saruman, Flat Earth Granny, Me Now, Del Third with the Facts, Daughter of the Most High, Serenity Davis, Sweetener Angel, James Smith, Amiki, Champion of Course, Chris Callow, Maggie S, T Davis, Nancy Militon, Goody MFLA, Nancy Ray, Unearthed Truths, Betty Smooth, Miss Ravenwood, Hirkiner, Buett, Jay Peterson, Not Your Average Wife, Kit Kat, Miss V, Noel Gatt, Merkaver Telek, Patricia Gross, E. Lapp, Tyrants Williams, Caring One, Kareem Davis, The Real, Bobby Joe, Egypt Neptives, K9 the Swim Coach, or K9 Swim Coach, Joseph Urbeso, Veronica Blonde, Dana Lisa, Who's That Girl, Deluxe, Diana Williams, Alphabet Soup, Shannon H., Aris Yah, John Moody, Ray Wright, Miss Davis, Tamaris Davis, Cynthia Travis, Markeisha, Kimberly Little, AC Israel. There's so many more to name. I just can't name them all. And I know I stumbled over some words. But, you know, again, thank you. Thank you. And to the new listeners who are joining this truth, welcome to Real TV. I'm Michael Israel, your host. We'll be back after this short break with Place Your Vote. What does it mean? What are we talking about? We'll talk about it right after this slow dance. It's good to dance. Yeah.
I just want to talk to you for a little bit. I got to talk to you for a little bit. I see you in your all red dress, looking like a wine punch. My gosh, would love to take you out to lunch. Bow tie, black shoes, me and you. And you know I gotta wear tux. You deserve the finer things in life. Diamond rings and anything you need. Diamond rings and everything you need. And I love to listen. don't wanna talk about your beauty. I just wanna talk about the way that you are as a human being. Cause the way you make me feel, babe, I can't explain. So I had to get a track. I had to call my homeboy up to make a track, just to tell you how I feel on this track. And I'm hoping that you know, hope you understand, that I wanna have this dance with you tonight, baby. So let's slow dance tonight, baby. Yeah. And I love the way your smile is, and I love the way our time is, when we spending quality time together, and we holding hands in the city, and I remember our first trip to New York, and I tripped up on that part, but I'm glad you got my heart. I'm glad that I met you. I know I can't sing, but I need to let you know that I'm so glad to have this dance with you. To have this dance with you is so special. Let's slow dance. I know I can't sing, babe, but I hope you like the melody. I hope you like the melody. If I hit the studio, I'ma make you one. I'd make you a whole album if I had the money and the time to do it on one take. We can go somewhere on spring break. Maybe Cancun, had the money, hit the moon. If I had the moon, I'd probably give you cheese. And if I had the hair store, I'd give you weave. And if I was a drug man, I'd give you weed. But I ain't that. I ain't that. And I don't smoke.
It's always a delight to bring you the realness, and you know how we do it on Real TV, baby. If this is your first time tuning in, you're in for a treat. You weren't brought here by algorithm. You're brought here because you need to know something important. Yeah, let's go ahead and get it started. All right, so today's show is called Place Your Vote. A lot of people went to the boxes a few days ago to vote for their mayor, governor, midterm elections. Why? Why are you voting? Did you vote? And what does placing your vote really means? Logically and common sense, we are energy beings. Energy cannot be diminished. It can't be destroyed. It is something that is forever, like the waves in the sea. The waves in the sea may be still at one point, but the waves are a continuance. The wind is a continuance. Our soul within us is a continuance in the afterlife. Our breath itself is just one breath that our Heavenly Father breathed through our nostrils when He created us from dust. And from this same breath, we inhale and exhale on that same one breath our entire lives. That energy, though it seems like it is diminished once we are deceased from this world because we're no longer breathing in a human body, but that last set of breath that we take or exhale once we officially die in this world goes back into the atmosphere, goes back to the trees, goes back to the grass, goes back to the flowers, which then uses it as energy to give back to us. So energy exists, and energy causes things to
let's just say, swerve into a certain direction depending on how many people are devoting their energy to this one thing. Sort of like the walls of Jericho. When there was a seven laps around this wall, and all in one unison, the Jews yelled in one voice and the walls fell down. With the power from our Heavenly Father who created us into His own image, and with the majesty that was placed within us, we used our voices to bring down that wall in energy. So what I'm saying is this. When people vote, where do they do so? Right? You have to go to a voting terminal or what they would like to call a polling station, right? So people are literally voting. Wow. Look at Oz. You hear that? May the Most High bless the suspect and or victim and the workers who are going to aid. All right. If you heard that siren in the background, it's a little ironic how that happened. As soon as I say voting, people are voting like a lightning vote, not voting. There's a difference because the person is selected, not elected. We'll get into that in just a moment. But people are voting, not voting, because they're going to the polls, which are the electric battery poles, that's like a positive and negative energy, right? To place their votes, to place like their lightning votes or their energy votes on a candidate that they want to see in charge. Like you have to charge a battery, charge your phone, right? You're placing your vote or your voltage in the candidate that you want to see in charge. That's why this politician, or you could say the politician, poll, right? Because you're going to the poll to vote for a politician or a politician. You're going to vote for a politician. And this politician receives the most votes, like your battery vote, your lightning vote. They don't receive votes. It's a difference. They're receiving votes. They're receiving your energy votes. So the politician that wins receives the most energy votes that the people sent their energy to, right? So this is the one thing that is going to put the person in power, in position. That's why they call it the power politics. They call it the power of politics, right? They call it the electoral college of electors or electoral votes. You have electrons, you have protons, positive energy, negative energy. These are the things that determine who will be president, even though they're going to select the one that they want to be anyways. It's not your paper or electronic vote that you punch into a machine that is actually giving this politician the right to reign supreme in his politic duties, if you will. I hope I didn't throw you too far on the loop there. I want to make this show short because it's not that hard to understand. When a person goes to vote, you're basically saying that, in essence, in a roundabout way, is that I'm voting for either Freemason number one or Freemason number two. Either way, they're Freemasons. They're part of the Order of Eastern Star. If they're a lady, there are Lady Masons also. Or they're part of some type of sorority or fraternal group that is under an umbrella of Satanism, because it all boils down to Satanism. Any 33rd degree Mason that makes it to that tier will tell you that Mason principles are based on Luciferian knowledge. It is the fallen angel Satan who directs and constructs this whole Masonic thing. If that makes any sense. So you're voting, either one, voting for a Mason, you're voting for a frat or sorority brother or sister that's a part of the brotherhood, like thinking that your vote is going to bring change, to bring a sense of democracy, if people would like to see or say. But when you look at the terms and break down the etymology of the word democracy, you have demo, which is similar to demo, right? And then you have crisi, which is a term in Latin that means kratos. So you have ruler, which means kratos, right? Or crisi, the ruler of. So you have demonic rulership. So then you have others that say, well, if you don't place your vote, then you don't have anything to say. You shouldn't say anything about the laws or anything that's going on in the world because you didn't vote. Or you can't, how can I say, how do you choose between the two lesser evils? Well, they're all a part of the same boat. They're all a part of the same team. Put it like this. If that person or that politician is not talking anything heavenly, not talking about anything that is majestic or eternal, that has to do with anything about going to heaven, trying to save our souls, trying to rid the evil in the world, then why are you voting for them anyway? Because they say separate church from state and all this stuff. No, get somebody real that's talking about some real stuff. We know what happens to someone that's somewhat of a real presidential type of candidate, like JFK. We know what happened to him. So what exactly are you placing your vote for? It's like the story of Yeshua and Barnabas. There's a story of, I want to say Barnabas or Barabbas. Let me see. Is it Barabbas? Barabbas. Let's find this here. There's a scripture. Okay. There's a scripture that has to do with placing your vote. And this is the only time it mattered. In this evil world, it doesn't matter right now who you vote for because you have two sides that are both evil. Like the picture that you see here with the elephant and the donkey, they're literally letting you know that it's about a circus. You have an elephant and you have a donkey, which are two animals that are both in a circus. So why are you placing your vote? Why do you think that there is hope for this world when you can't even realize that we are under the rulership of England? Well, you think, how so? Well, didn't the settlers come from Britain? They came from England to the quote-unquote New World, and when they got here, they called it New England, right? That's why you have New Hampshire, which is in New England, right? What am I saying before I get off the track? I should have took some notes. Okay. Let me see, where we at? We almost at 30 minutes. Let's make this short. So what I'm trying to say is this. Some of us don't even know some of the basic terms and what it mean or the symbology of things like lawyers. Lawyers, for instance, are under the rulership of Britain. For a person to become a lawyer, they have to pass the what you will call the bar exam. The bar exam is a cluster of different tests. Pardon me, is a cluster of different questions to answer. And it's so demonic and lucrative and evil in ways that when they take this test, not all lawyers get the full test. Some lawyers just get a blank sheet of paper. They get a blank sheet of paper and then they become a lawyer. And then you wonder why they finished their test so fast. It's because they were selected to become a lawyer all along. Maybe their dad was a judge. Their mother was a judge. They're a Jesuit or have some dealings with Satanism or Luciferianism or whatever have you. And they didn't have to take the test. But they have to pass what you call a bar exam. And you have to know what bar means. What is bar? Bar is the British accredited registration. Every lawyer is a certified, what you would call, British ambassador for the Queen of England. They are under the Queen of England rulership. And if you don't think that London doesn't rule the United States, then you're wrong. And you have to do a little bit more research. London is the monetary system of the world. The Vatican City is like the religion of the world. And then you have Washington, D.C., which is about the military power of the world, right? So, in essence, you have a lawyer who is given to one who reaches out for one, or you could get an attorney, but typically, if you have a court case, you have a lawyer, right, to speak for you because they consider you civilly dead. And that lawyer has to speak on behalf of you. And that judge is a mediator between the United States Corporation and the Queen of England. The judge has no power in the courtroom. You would think that he does, but the clerk is the powerful one in the courtroom. But before we get off on a rampant, and I do want to make this show short, it's about place your vote. And when you go to Matthew chapter 27, verses 26 through 28, it reads, "Then release Barabbas," or Barabbas, "unto them. And when he had scourged Yeshua, he delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Yeshua into the common hall and gathered him, the whole band of soldiers. And they stripped him and put him in a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed the knee before him and mocked him, saying, 'Hail, King of the Jews.' And they spit on him and they took the reed and smote him on the head. And after that, they mocked him. They took the robe off from him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. Him they compelled to bear his cross. And when they were coming to a place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of a skull, they gave him vinegar to drink mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And they crucified him and parted his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, 'They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots.' And sitting down, they watched him there and set up over his head an accusation written, 'This is Yeshua, the King of Jews.' Then there were two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and the other on the left." I read a little bit more than I wanted to read. But as you dive into the scripture, you'll realize that they had an option. They had an option to release this person who committed a crime named Barabbas, or they had an option to release Yeshua, who was sin free, who didn't do any sin, and he was all about his father's business. They had a chance to place their vote for the literal lesser of the evil. They had a chance to vote for someone who was sin free, completely sin free. And they chose not to do it. They rather someone who committed a crime. They cheered for him as this criminal was released. So, if we're not placing our vote for somebody that is angelic or someone that is about our father's business, then why are we placing a vote? We're living in the end times. We're living in the end times, literally. Things are going to come to pass that are breathtaking, so much so that one would faint 10 times over. Earthquakes beyond imagination. Starvation as a whole. When the grid goes down, the electrical grid goes down, will you be glad that you place your vote for this mayor or governor that is all about martial law? All they're trying to do is continue to have their people in office to bring about the agenda. And once they have enough resources, enough money, and enough things to fund their underground domes and plentiful food and protection and their little bunkers and things, they're going to cause a race war. They're going to cause mass destruction in major cities. There's going to be laser drones. There's going to be robotoids. There's going to be androids and synthetics that have human consciousness in them. And they won't have no need for human beings because they're going to have robotics that can do the work, that are faster and smarter. They have no need for a mass majority of human beings because they created clones, androids, and synthetic human beings with a human consciousness that are nothing more than demons resurrected. And then the 500,000, or pardon me, or the 500 million people that they want alive are just going to be docile slaves that are going to be chipped with the mark of the beast. So all these people that are being voted for, if they're not talking about some real stuff like don't get the mark of the beast, if they're not talking about some real stuff like we all need to get to heaven, we all need to live right, then why are we placing our vote thinking that there's going to be a change? They're going to have Hummers dropped from helicopters, men in all black, raid neighborhoods, knock on your door, and take you to the FEMA camp. And you thought that your vote was going to protect you. When the grid goes down and there's no food in the stores, you would have thought that they would have sent you a care package full of food, goods, and supplies and protection gear that will last you until the world comes back together. But you don't see them talking about anything like that. I don't want to get too deep into the show about placing your vote, because it's all common sense that we shouldn't be voting. A lot of black people want to vote or think that we should vote in a nation that didn't want us to vote or want us in the nation to begin with. So we're brought to this place called North of America, where we were slaves, and They mistreated us. They killed us. They did so many heinous things to us. Yet, we want to be a part of their world so bad that during the mid-1900s and the early 1920s, there were so many revolts of just trying so hard just to so-called be equal, forgetting the truth that when we call ourselves black, but since it's a common phrase, we do it, but when we acknowledge ourselves as black or African Americans, we are considered 3/5 of a human being. Don't even consider us human to this day. Yet we want to vote and we think that placing our vote is going to bring change. Yet you have others who wanted to vote for President Obama, who under his presidency, there were so many blacks that were being killed that he had basically continual rituals throughout his entire presidency. He didn't say anything about all those 300 plus black people that were being killed left and right. Except one thing, that Trayvon Martin could be his son. Yet, when people place their vote at that time, they assumed that change was going to be brought about. So the Caucasians that knew that they were in white privilege or under white supremacy, they felt that equality could come about if they would just cast their vote for Obama. You know, maybe things would change. You know, it would be good to see someone in office, right? So let's just place our vote for Obama. Then you have black people who are just going to vote for the color of his skin. And then you have another set of black people who are going to vote for him because they're part of fraternities and sororities and the Masonic order. And then you have another part of black people who are, quote unquote, voting for change because they want to see a real, quote unquote, black leader. Right? So you have these different scenarios that seems like it's legit, but it's not. Obama reeled in the privilege for gays in many ways, which I'm not judging, but that approval for people that are gay and a part of LGBT just basically led a thread to other situations that are detrimental because of that first approval. Now, it's not just LGBT, but they're adding it to be LGBTQP. They're adding queer and they're adding pedophilia to it. So not only did you allow the rights for gays, but now they're trying to allot the rights for pedophilia. It's like not only is Canada allowing marijuana, people place their votes for that. Not only did Mexico allow the rites of passage for marijuana in their country also, right? But you have many states, over 30 in the U.S. that are allowing marijuana. But it's a threat to other things that are to come about. Recently, there was an article saying that they're going to allow psychedelic mushrooms and LSD and ecstasy to become legalized in the U.S., so it sounds like it's okay at first. But the question is, what did you place your vote for? We only need to place our vote for one person. And that is our Heavenly Father, who is right in all ways, who has the greatest love and mercy and truth and everything that is good. That's who we need to be placing our vote for. Real TV.